ಸರ್ ಬರೀ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಶೇರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಾ ಸರ್ ಅದು ಅನೋಟೇಷನ್ ಅದೇನು ಬೇಡ ಸರ್ ಓಕೆ ಸರ್ Good afternoon, students. So today we are going to discuss few questions are from Wiley. We have taken the questions from Wiley. Okay. So the first question that is appearing on your screen. Hope the questions are clear. Okay. And the question is appearing on the screen. So the first question here is the wavelength of light to carry out photosynthesis in bacteria is. Please read the question properly and then answer the question. Here it is saying that the wavelength of the light that is required to carry out photosynthesis in bacteria. So in bacteria, the wavelength of the light that is used for photosynthesis, it is ultraviolet light. Okay. And the wavelength of this light ranges between 100 to 390 nanometers. Whereas in higher plants, blue and red are the wavelength of the light that has been used for photosynthesis. B, option one, that is ultraviolet rays. Okay. Coming to next is the second question. Dash performed an elegant experiment with the Dash plant to show that in bright sunlight, small bubbles were formed around the Dash plants, while in dark, they do not. Okay, we are supposed to identify the person who conducted the experiment, what was the plant that was being used for the experiment, and what was the result. So if you see here, Dash performed, the name of the biologist who performed the experiment was Engine House, and the plant that was being used by Engine House was an aquatic plant, and what was the outcome of the result was small bubbles were found around the green parts of the plant body. Okay, that too only in the bright light, but these bubbles disappeared when it was dark. Okay, so hence the answer for this question would be the first option, that is Engine House, aquatic plant and green. What were these small bubbles? The small bubbles, later it was being found out that they are the oxygen. Okay, so hence option one is the right answer. Moving on to the next question on your screen. Who showed that sunlight is essential to the plant process that purifies the air that was fouled or contaminated by burning candles or breathing animals? Okay, you are supposed to now identify the biologist who conducted this experiment. So this experiment was being conducted by Joseph Priestley. Okay, so Joseph Priestley was the one who conducted this experiment to show that the plants purified whatever the air was being polluted by burning the candle or by breathing of the animals. And this purification of the air was being done because of the release of oxygen. And how was the air being fouled, or maybe how was it contaminated? Due to the release of carbon dioxide by both burning candle and as well as by the breathing animals. So hence the right option is the second option. So if you see the if you have studied the NCERT textbook thoroughly, the question is directly from the NCERT question. Next question: by using Dash isotope, it can be proved that oxygen is released from water during photosynthesis. This experiment was being conducted to show that during photosynthesis, oxygen was being evolved. So what was the isotope that was being used? So for the experiment, it was the radioactive isotope that was being used, that is O18. O18 was the radioactive isotope that was being used to prove that the oxygen is the one that was being released from water during photosynthesis. Next question. T.W. Engelmann used chemotactic aerobic bacteria and a filamentous green alga for the study of. Okay, now we have to identify here which was, or maybe what was the outcome of the Engelmann's experiment, or what did he prove that. But before that, the filamentous green algae that was being used was Cladophora, and a chemotactic aerobic bacteria was being used. So during this experiment, we see that the aerobic bacteria, they got aggregated or accumulated in the range of blue and as well as red light, showing the action spectra. So thus, T.W. Engelmann was the first one to show the action spectra of the light, that is blue as well as the red light. So hence the option here, I think, would be the third option, that is action spectra of a photosynthesis. Coming to the next question. So hope along with me, if you can read the question and then answer by yourself. So, we are there to help you all out, but try to read the question and then try to yourself also an answer. Okay. Coming to the next question, fill in the blanks in the following paragraph and select the option with all correct answers. The LHC, that is light harvesting complex, are made up of hundreds of pigment molecules bound to A would be protein. Each photosystem has all the pigments except one molecule of chlorophyll A, forming the light harvesting system called the antennae. So B is antennae. These pigments help to make photosynthesis more efficient by absorbing different wavelength of light. The single chlorophyll A molecule forms the the reaction center. The splitting of water is associated with photosystem two. So these are the answer for all the option. Okay, now but we are supposed to select the right option. First option, you see A is a protein, is not reaction center. What is B? B is antennae, so we cannot go with the first option. Second, C is a different. Okay, correct. D is antennae. Okay, D is antennae. Is D antennae? No, D is reaction center. Then third option, B is antennae, correct, whereas E is photosystem 2. That is also correct. So hence, I think the right answer is answer, that is option 3. Option 3 is the right answer. Hope you all are getting the, you hope you have got the question and the answer for this question. Okay. Moving on to the next question. In the below graph, A, B and C represents respectively. Means you are supposed to select what is A, what is B and what is C. I think this is the graph that is depicting the absorption spectra. Okay, Andhra, the different pigments are able to absorb different wavelength of light. So now A, B, C you are supposed to select. Can anyone guess what is A? Okay, if you see A is chlorophyll B. Then if you see B, it is carotenoid. Whereas if you see it is C, if you see it is chlorophyll A. Okay, so NCERT, the graph, if you refer to the NCERT textbook, it's the same graph it is. Okay, so hence the option here is the second option. A is chlorophyll B, then B is carotenoids, whereas C is chlorophyll A. Coming to the next question, photosystem 1 absorbs. Okay, so now basically in this session we are discussing the introductory part of the chapter and as well as the requirement for photosynthesis. Okay, now if you see here, all the pigment molecules are being arranged in discrete two units, one called photosystem 1 and another called as the photosystem 2. Okay, and photosystem 1 and photosystem 2 absorb the different wavelength of light. photosystem 1 is able to absorb the wavelength of light in 700 nanometer and less than 700 nanometer. Okay, so hence the option if you see here would be the second option, that is 700 nanometer and less than 700 nanometer of light. Okay, so whereas the photosystem 2, what is the photosystem 2 reaction center? The photosystem 2's reaction center is 680, okay, which is said to be right, it is said to be the reaction center for photosystem 2. Okay, so for photosystem 1, please remember the reaction center is 700. It has been named as 700. Why? Because it is able to absorb wavelength of light 700 nanometer as well as be less than 700 nanometer. Okay, next question. Okay, the membrane of a stroma lamellae lacks. Okay, now you can see the picture here, right? There is a diagram that has been given here. It shows about the thylakoid, right? We know that many of the thylakoid, they are piled upon each other to form the grana. Okay, so those thylakoids that are being piled up, right, you can see here, these are the granal thylakoids, whereas there are few thylakoids which are not stacked or maybe which are not piled, you call them as the stromal thylakoid or the stroma lamellae. Okay, you refer it as even stroma lamellae. Okay, so now here in the question it is asked, the membrane of a stroma lamellae lacks. Okay, now once again I'm coming back to the diagram. When you look at the diagram, right, you see here these are the thylakoids which are said to be appraised thylakoid. Please look at the pointer that I am using. These are the appraised thylakoid, whereas these are non-appraised thylakoid. So the appraised thylakoid, if you see, it has got photosystem 2. Okay, whereas this one is called as non-appraised thylakoid. Non-appraised thylakoid has photosystem 1. Along with the photosystem 1, it has also electron carrying system, that is cytochrome, and as well as an ATP synthetase enzyme for the synthesis of ATP. Okay, so now in the question it is asked, membrane of a stromal lamellae lacks. Okay, the membrane of the stromal lamellae, now this is the membrane of the stromal lamellae, has what all it has? It has got ATP synthetase, it has got photosystem 1, it has also got what called as cytochrome BF complex. What is absent here or what is lacking here? There is one which is lacking, and that is photosystem 2. So photosystem 2 is absent, or maybe you can tell the stromal lamellae lacks photosystem 2. Whereas, remember, right, in the granal thylakoid, you find, especially in the appraised thylakoid, you find photosystem 2. Whereas photosystem 2 are absent in the stromal lamellae. So hence, the option for this answer would be, okay, along with the photosystem 2, right, in the NCERT textbook, it is given that, right, you see that the stromal thylakoid also lacks an another important enzyme called as NADP reductase enzyme, okay, which is basically required for the synthesis of a reducing substance called as NADPH2. Okay, so hence please remember here the option for this question is more than one option are correct. Which are the two options which are correct? One is photosystem 2, whereas the second one is the third one, that is NADP reductase enzyme. Okay, so this question, fourth option is the right answer. Okay, going on to the next question. Which of the following is incorrect regarding photosystem? Okay, we are supposed to select the there are two photosystem. We all know that there are two photosystem 1 and photosystem 2. Photosystem 1 and photosystem 2 are being named in the sequence of their discovery. Directly NCERT statement it is. Okay. Why are they named as photosystem 1 and photosystem 2? They are named basically based on the sequence of their discovery. Third, light harvesting complex is made up of hundreds of pigment molecules which have got a bounded proteins. This is also correct. So when there are hundreds of pigment molecules bound to protein, what do you call this system? It is called as the antennae. Okay, it is referred as the antennae. Fourth statement, each photosystem has all the pigment except one molecule of chlorophyll A forming the light harvesting system called as the antennae. It is asking about the photosystem. So when you see about the photosystem, the fourth option is the incorrect statement. Am I clear here? Okay, right. You see here the light harvesting complex, light harvesting complex containing the pigments is called as the antennae, right? It is not called as the what you call it as the photosystem. So hence the incorrect statement would be the fourth option. Hope you have understood this question. Okay, you have to remember photosystem have got three important components: chlorophyll A molecule, second is light harvesting which forms the antennae. It is basically involved in absorbing the light energy and then passing on to the reaction center, whereas the third is the electron carrying system. Okay, so here answer or the fourth option would be the right answer. Coming to the next question on your screen, where does water splitting complex associated with the photosystem 2 complex is situated? Let me tell you that photosystem 1 and photosystem 2, already I have told, there are three important components. What are they? First one, reaction center. Second, light harvesting complex. Third, electron carriers. But photosystem 2 has an additional complex. What is this additional complex called as? This additional complex is called as the OEC, that is oxygen evolving complex. So where is this oxygen evolving complex present? This oxygen evolving complex is present in the inner membrane of the thylakoid. Okay, the inner side. Okay, the thylakoid has the membrane. You call it as the thylakoid membrane. Then the thylakoid membrane inside or maybe encloses a space called as the lumen. Okay, so the inner side of the membrane has this complex called as the OEC complex, which is basically involved in splitting of water. So hence the answer for this question would be the second option, that is the inner side of the thylakoid membrane. Hope you have understood. Please remember OEC is the complex. So that is oxygen evolving complex, which is basically involved in splitting of water. Water gets split to release or maybe for the evolution of oxygen. Coming to the next question. Okay. Which of the following statement is false? Which of the following statement is false? Usually chloroplasts align themselves along the wall of the chlorophyll cells so that they get optimum quantity of incident light. When there is a bright light within the mesophyll cells, the chloroplast arranged on the outer wall along the wall of the chloroplast. I mean, or along the wall of the mesophyll cells. But when the light is dim, please on the tangential wall, they get arranged. Okay, so it is a correct statement. Second, within chloroplast, there is a membranous system consisting of grana, then stromal lamellae, and as well as the stroma. Right, this is also correct. Yes. Chloroplast has got, what are the parts of a chloroplast? It has got membrane, then it has got grana, then it has got stromal lamellae, and as well as it has got the stroma. What is stromal lamellae also called as? They are called as the fruit. Okay, it is also a correct statement. It mainly tells about the structure of chloroplast. Third, rubisco is the most abundant protein found within the chloroplast, right? Rubisco is the most abundant protein found within the chloroplast. Yes. Okay. Right. this is also the right, but false. We are supposed to identify the false statement. Go to the fourth statement. In grana, carbon dioxide is fixed. Where is carbon dioxide fixed? Carbon dioxide is fixed not in the grana, but it is fixed in the stroma. Hence, the false statement would be the fourth statement, that is, in grana, carbon dioxide is fixed. Okay, it's a false statement. Then where is carbon dioxide fixed? Carbon dioxide is fixed in the stroma. When? During dark reaction. Okay, you should know entire process of photosynthesis, please remember, has been broadly divided as light reaction and dark reaction. During light reaction, water is used, whereas during dark reaction, carbon dioxide is used, where carbon dioxide is fixed or carbon dioxide is reduced. Where does this dark reaction occurs? In the stroma. Next question. The membranous system of grana is responsible for the membranous system. Okay. The membranous system of grana, okay, is responsible for three things. One, trapping of the solar energy. Second, it is involved in the synthesis of ATP. Third, it is also involved in the formation of a reducing substance called as NADPH2. All the three, it is involved in all these three. So hence, if you see these, all the four statements, first statement, what does the first statement tells? Trapping light energy, but not ATP and NADPH. Wrong. It, along with trapping energy, it also synthesizes ATP as well as NADPH2. Second, trapping light energy and also a fixation of carbon dioxide. Yes, right? For ATP synthesis formation, but not for light trapping. No, wrong. Okay. Whereas the fourth statement, for light capturing and also for the formation of NADPH2 as well as ATP. So, the right option here, I think it is, right, the fourth option. Coming to the next question. The light harvesting complex is made up of, I have told you, the photosystem is made up of how many components? One, reaction center made up of chlorophyll A molecule. Second, light harvesting complex made up of hundreds of molecules of pigment molecules. Third, electron transport or maybe electron carriers. Okay, now here in the question, what is asked? Light harvesting complex. Andre, what is light harvesting complex made up of? Light harvesting complex is made up of only one molecule of chlorophyll A molecule. No, wrong. Okay, it forms what? Reaction center. Only few molecule of chlorophyll A molecule. That is also wrong. Okay, right. So, third option, hundreds of pigment molecule bound to protein. So, this is the right answer. Okay, so, right. So, we see the third option is the right answer for the question. Chlorophyll A, chlorophyll C, protein and DNA are the wrong answer because it has been jumbled up with the different components. Okay, so we are not going with the fourth option, but we are going with the third option, which is the right answer for the question. Then next question. In which of the following cells of a C3 leaf would you find the highest concentration of enzyme Rubisco? Where is Rubisco present? In the chloroplast, stroma of the chloroplast. Okay, right. But where are chloroplast present? That too in the C3 plants. Okay, in C3 plants, enzyme Rubisco is basically found in the mesophyll cells. If we would have gone by, if there instead of C3, C4 plants idre, then we would have gone with the bundle sheath. But in the question, it is asked the C3 plants. So in C3 plants or in the C3 leaf, where is Rubisco present? It is basically present in the mesophyll cells. Mesophyll cells na yelli chloroplast. Chloroplast, within the chloroplast, where is Rubisco present? In the stroma. So hence, the right answer is the mesophyll cells. Next question. Pigments are organized into two discrete photochemical light harvesting complex within the photosystem 1 and photosystem 2. We know that. They are been named according to. How are they named? I think already we discussed this. How are they named? They are been named in the sequence of their discoveries, not based on their function nor based on their arrangement of the chlorophyll, right? You have to know that they are basically named based on the sequence of their discovery. Hence, the first option is the right option for this question. Coming to next question. Okay, this is very important. Okay, look at the question. Which of the following is a constituent of the ring structure of chlorophyll and also help to maintain the ribosome structure? In the last chapter, that is mineral nutrition, we have studied that used for the formation of the structure of chlorophyll is magnesium. Look at the picture that is, or the diagram that has been given here. This is a chlorophyll A molecule. I'll be dealing with the structure of the chlorophyll in the next few questions. Okay. Now, when you look here in the structure, okay, right, this is the head. It is called as the head, whereas this one is called as the tail. So, when you see in the head, okay, in the center, the core of the head molecule, you will see the magnesium. Okay, so which is the important element that is responsible for the ring structure of the chlorophyll and as well as it will help in maintaining the ribosome structure? It is magnesium. Ribosome structure andaga, right, you have to remember smaller and larger subunit. Larger and smaller subunit are joined with the help of magnesium. Okay, so hence option 4 is the right answer. Coming to the next question. Choose the incorrect statement with respect to photosystem 1. Photosystem 1 bagge now, yavudu incorrect statement idena adanna now select madbeku. What is it? First, concentration of chlorophyll is A, chlorophyll A is more than chlorophyll B. Of course, it is correct. Chlorophyll A is more in concentration than compared to chlorophyll B. It is found in both grana and stromal lamellae. Photosystem 1 is present in both the grana and as well as stromal lamellae. Previous nagli discuss madidene, right, in my previous discussion I told you all it is found on the granule and as well as the stromal lamellae. In both you find photosystem 1, correct statement. Third, participates only in cyclic flow of electrons, cyclic, involved in both cyclic and as well as non-cyclic photophosphorylation. It is not just involved only in cyclic. My students, listen, it is involved in both photosystem 1 as well as photosystem 2. Hence, the answer or the incorrect statement is the third statement. What about the fourth statement? The reaction center constitutes the P700. Yes, correct. No, what is the reaction center of photosystem 1? The reaction center of photosystem 1 is P700. Okay, so the option for this question is the third option. Coming to the next question on your screen, each quantosome consists of what are quantosomes? What are quantosomes? It was this particular term was being previously been used. Of course, it is not now in usage. Now, instead of quantosome, we are using the term photosystem. Okay. So, what are quantosomes? Quantosomes are a cluster of pigment molecules. A cluster or a group of pigment molecule, you call it as a quantosome. So, what does actually a quantosome is known to consist of? Quantosome is known to consist of around 230 chlorophyll molecule. How many? 230 chlorophyll molecule, out of which 160 are chlorophyll A, whereas 70 are chlorophyll B. So, if you know this content of the quantosomes, so we come or we arrive at the right option, that is third one, with the 230 chlorophyll molecules, in which chlorophyll A is around 160, whereas chlorophyll B 70 molecules respectively. Okay, next question. Photosystem is composed of, right, I have already been telling and repeatedly I am repeating this, that is, what does photosystem known to contain? One, reaction center. Second, light harvesting complex. Third, it is known to contain an electron carrier system. Okay, of course, right, what is present here? It is what it has light harvesting complex, it has reaction center. Light harvesting complex has got accessory pigments. Okay, so hence the right option here would be the fourth option, that is more than one option is correct here. So we are going with the fourth option for this question. Next question. Reaction center of photosystem 1 is, what is the reaction center of photosystem 1? It is 700 P 700. Why? Because it is able to absorb wavelength of 700 nanometer. What about photosystem 2? Photosystem 2, the reaction center is 680. So if that is the case, so we are going with the option here, the second option, that is P700 and P680. Okay, next question. Cytochrome is, okay, cytochrome are the electron carriers that are being associated with the photosystem. What are basically, chemically, what are they? Okay, cytochrome, if you see, it is an iron containing porphyrin pigment. Okay, it is an iron containing porphyrin pigment, which is not involved in absorption of light, but it is basically involved in the transfer of electrons. Hence, option 2 is the right answer for this question. Next question. The main difference between chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B, right? For this, I would like to go with the a picture or a diagram here. Okay. Now, on the screen, we are able to see the structure of both chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B. Hope the structure are clear on your screen. Okay. Now, when you look at the structure, the structure of chlorophyll has got two parts. The structure looks like a tadpole larva, okay, or a tadpole. It has a head and it has a tail, okay. The head is called as the porphyrin head, whereas the tail is called as the phytol tail, okay, right. So, this particular head region, right, the head region is basically consisting of four pyrrole rings. There are pyrrole rings present here. Four, 1, 2, 3, and 4 rings are present. Each ring has got 5 atoms with the 4 carbon atom and 1 nitrogen atom, which is found towards the center. And then there is a magnesium. So the structure remains the same for both chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B. Then what is the difference? The difference, when you see, if you see here, there is a box, red color box is there. In chlorophyll A, the 3rd carbon atom has methyl group, CH3. Whereas in chlorophyll B, the 3rd carbon atom has an aldehyde group. So the difference between chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B is, one is the 3rd carbon atom has a methyl group, whereas chlorophyll B at the 3rd carbon atom, it has got an aldehyde group. Okay. And if you see the empirical formula for the chlorophyll A is C55H72O5N4Mg, whereas for chlorophyll B, it is C55H70O6N4Mg. When you see here, hydrogen atom are more in chlorophyll A, whereas 2 hydrogen atom are less in chlorophyll B. Then oxygen atom are 5 in chlorophyll A, whereas in chlorophyll B, there are 6 oxygen atom. Okay, so now we will go back to the question and we will see the option. Now I have explained to you about the structure of the chlorophyll. Now let us see what is the difference. We have already seen the difference. Let us see if those differences are found in the option. First one, chlorophyll A is a linear chain compound and B is a branched chain. Wrong. Chlorophyll A has no magnesium. Magnesium is not there in chlorophyll A. No, magnesium is present. If magnesium is absent, then it is not chlorophyll A, then it is pyophytic. Okay. So hence, second option is wrong. Third, you see, chlorophyll A has CH3 group, whereas B has CHO group, which we have already seen in the diagram. Okay, if you want, I would like to show you once again the structure of both chlorophyll A and as well as chlorophyll B. So the option, the right option would be option 3 for this question. So coming to the next question. In the schematic diagram shown below, which is plastocyanin? Okay, this is cyclic or non-cyclic photophosphorylation. It is non-cyclic photophosphorylation. Okay, in the non-cyclic photophosphorylation, we see the involvement of both photosystem 2 and as well as photosystem 1. Okay, now in the question, given question, please remember, we are supposed to identify plastocyanin. Okay, plastocyanin, D is plastocyanin. Then what are the rest? Okay, let us see. A is pheophytin. B is phytoquinone A, then B, then cytochrome BF complex, whereas D is plastocyanin. Plastocyanin is an electron carrier which connects both photosystem 2 as well as photosystem 1. Hence, right, in the diagram, plastocyanin is D. Okay, so the option would be the second option. Okay, next question. Cyclic photophosphorylation results in the formation of, what do you mean by cyclic? Cyclic because the electrons that are been expelled out of the photosystem are cycled back to the photosystem. Photophosphorylation, what do you mean by photophosphorylation? It is synthesis of ATP from ADP. When it is occurring in the presence of sunlight, you call it as photophosphorylation. During photophosphorylation, only ATP is synthesized. So hence, the option would be the fourth option where only ATP is synthesized. Right? Let me tell you here, non-cyclic photophosphorylation, nalli, both ATP and NADPH2 is being synthesized along with the evolution of oxygen. When does it occur? Non-cyclic. But question nalli namge en kelidara? In the question, they have asked about cyclic. So hence option is the fourth option, that is ATP. Then coming to the next question on the screen. In photosystem 1, the first electron acceptor is photosystem 1 nalli, which is the first electron acceptor. The first electron acceptor here is an iron sulfur containing protein. Okay, so fourth option is the right answer. Okay, right, if you see. But before that, there will be even A0 and as well as A1. Okay, right, but anyway, so the first electron acceptor in the photosystem 1 is an iron sulfur containing protein. Okay, so fourth option is the right answer. Next question. Okay, be careful. Question is a little bit big. A student set up an experiment on photosynthesis as follows. Okay, what was the protocol that he followed for his experiment? He takes soda water in a glass tumbler and keep the tumbler exposed to sunlight, hoping that he has provided all the necessary ingredients for photosynthesis to proceed. What were the ingredients he added? Carbon dioxide, water and chlorophyll and as well as light. What do you think will happen after or say a few hours of exposure to light? What would be the outcome of this experiment? Okay, let me tell you very clearly. For carrying out photosynthesis, if you provide only chlorophyll, that is not sufficient. You have to provide a chloroplast because photosynthesis is being carried out both in the grana and as well as the stroma. Okay, so hence, if you see with this, what you call it as a concept, if you see the right answer here, the right answer would be the fourth answer. Photosynthesis will not take place. Even though if you provide carbon dioxide, even though if you provide and as well as light, they will not be able to carry out photosynthesis. Why? Because right, a complete chloroplast is required for the carrying out of photosynthesis. Hence, the fourth option would be the incorrect statement or maybe our what you call it as conclusion. Then, next question. Water splitting complex is associated with what is it is associated with the which photosystem? What is water splitting complex known as? Water splitting complex is known as OEC, oxygen evolving complex, which is basically involved in the splitting of water. Okay, it is associated basically with photosystem 2. Okay, photosystem 1 does not have this system. So hence, right? Fourth option is the right answer. Right, as I have already told you all, please remember photosystem to the lee along with the three components, reaction center, LHC light harvesting complex and electron carrier, it has got a fourth component, and this fourth component you are calling it as oxygen evolving complex. It is basically involved in photolysis of water, which is called as water splitting. Okay, it's called as water splitting complex. So fourth option is the right answer. Next question. Light reactions or the photochemical phase do not include. Light reaction does not include. But first, let us understand in the light reaction of the chlorophyll molecule. Second is the what you call it as photophosphorylation. Right. Third step, what you see is the electron transport chain. Whereas the fourth one is the photolysis of water. These are the four steps involved in light reaction. I repeat, light reaction has four steps. Enenu modledagi photo excitation of the chlorophyll molecule. Second, it is photophosphorylation. Third, electron transport chain. Fourth, photolysis of water. You nalke irbeku. Apart from that, no other. Okay, now let us see the option. Absorption, light absorption. Yes, only when light is absorbed, then there will be what you call it as excitation of the chlorophyll molecule. Second, water splitting and oxygen release, photolysis of nothing but it is photolysis of water. It is also correct. Third, production of a sugar. When does the production of sugar occurs? Production of sugar does not occur during light reaction. Production of sugar occurs during dark reaction. Yes, you all are correct. Okay. The fourth option, nodri, the formation of high energy chemical intermediate ADP and NADPH2 are produced when? During light reaction. So light reaction does not include the third option, that is production of a sugar. So production of sugar is basically involved with the dark reaction and not with the light reaction. Next question. In photosystem 2, the reaction center chlorophyll A absorbs dash wavelength of red light, causing electrons to become excited and jump into an orbit from the atomic, that is away or far from the atomic nucleus. These electrons are picked up by an electron acceptor. Okay, C is what now? Acceptor, which passes them to an electron transport system consisting of DNO cytochrome. Okay, now what do you see? ANO, we have to find out the which is the photosystem. It is 680 nanometer. BNO, right? B is what? Farer. Okay, then C, what it is? Acceptor. Whereas D will be cytochrome. So hence the option would be, the right option would be the fourth option, 680 nanometer. And then the cytochromes. Next question. Dash is the basic pathway that results in the C3 as well as C4 plants. Okay, right. What is the common pathway which results in the sugar? Please remember, when is the sugar synthesized? I have told you in my last question, it is synthesized during the dark reaction. Okay. And what is the pathway or the cycle which is involved in the formation of sugar? It is nothing but Kelvin cycle. It may be for the C3 plants or it may be for the C4 plants. It is the Kelvin cycle. So hence, the fourth option is the right option.
Madam.
Come, sir.
It's time.
Sir. Oh, okay, sir. Okay, sir. I'll stop, sir. Okay, student, we'll continue in my next session.